Biofuel Boondoggle, America's Deadly Crime Against Humanity. A boondoggle is a project of little or no value that wastes time, money, and resources in order to appear to be doing something useful. The term was first used during the 1930s Great Depression about low-value jobs for the unemployed. Subsidizing the production of biofuels, like ethanol from corn, is a boondoggle contributing to the starvation of a billion needy people on Earth. American farmers do need subsidies, but not for biofuels from food for inefficient SUVs. United Nations energy and right to food experts like Gene Ziegler have said that it is a crime against humanity to divert land to the production of crops that are then burned for fuel. They are calling for a 5-year international ban against this outrageous biofuel practice, so the technology can be sorted out and foolish politicians educated. Nearly a billion humans are starving. America used to be a major exporter of food like corn and soy. Biofuel subsidies have diverted limited agricultural resources from food to bad fuel. Food prices have increased significantly worldwide. America now imports much of its food from low-quality foreign sources like Mexico, India, China, and more people are starving. Biofuel is produced with imported oil. Petroleum is used to cultivate, plant, fertilize, herbicides, pesticides, harvest, transport, heat, ferment, distill, and deliver biofuel to the retail pump. Corrosive ethanol has much lower energy content per gallon than the imported oil that is required to produce it. This crime against humanity is absolutely insane. If biofuel is used to grow and produce biofuel with no oil, coal, or natural gas, it would take 3/4 of the cultivated land on the face of the earth to supply biofuel for vehicles of 4.5% of world population in America. There would be very little land left for growing food for humans or animals, and no biofuel for any other country. This is beyond absurd and clearly ridiculous. But American politicians have just voted to subsidize this practice with $7 billion. There are many serious implications of our biofuel boondoggle. As America produces less of its own homegrown food, the quality of our substandard imported food supply is rapidly declining. 1/4 of us get food poisoning each year from low-quality, tainted food. There are 360 U.S. food import points, but only 90 of them have part-time federal food inspectors. Biofuels impact our national health. High fructose corn syrup is an unhealthy, cheap byproduct of producing ethanol from corn. It atrophies the pancreas, causing deadly diabetes even in children. It inhibits metabolism of collagen and elastin, the sinews that hold our body together. High fructose corn syrup targets our children and is in most of the products that they consume. Consider the extremely high price of biofuel. One SUV tank full of ethanol consumes enough corn to feed an adult for a whole year. 1 acre of modern, genetic-engineered, rapid-growth corn consumes about 4,000 gallons of scarce water per day. 1 acre of corn can power one small car about 1,440 miles per year. It would take over 8 acres of corn to power one car 12,000 miles per year. The worldwide population explosion has resulted in insufficient water for human subsistence. Infant mortality rate is directly linked to the growing lack of clean, fresh water. Global warming is now creating record droughts in some areas. Once great rivers no longer flow to the sea, like the Colorado and the Rio Grande in the United States, the Nile, Jordan, Indus, Murray, Yellow, and Oxus in Australia. Genetically engineered crops are very thirsty. We have over-extracted the water they need. Diverting land and water from food crops, like corn and soy, to make biofuels for inefficient SUVs contributes to starvation. In stark contrast to thirsty corn, only 14 by 14 feet, or 4.5 by 4.5 meters, of rooftop photovoltaic solar cells, plus modern battery electricity storage, can power an efficient electric car 12,000 miles per year. 1 acre of photovoltaic would power 212 cars 12,000 miles each and not consume any water. The 1800s internal combustion engine is an extremely inefficient concept that needs to be rapidly phased out. 86% of the energy in internal combustion engine fuel is converted into wasted heat. Biofuels are a bad attempt to preserve obsolete internal combustion engines. Electric motors are more powerful, more efficient, and cost much less. Let sunshine on your rooftop power your new 2010 General Motors rechargeable Volt or a new plug-in midsize Prius. When you understand the basic physics of energy, as no U.S. congressperson does today, you will know why raising crops for biofuel is not scalable and can never be cost-effective. Biofuels are merely a counterproductive boondoggle detour. Some politicians suggest that cellulosic ethanol from grass or wood chips is the future solution. Ruminants, like cows, eat grass, and an enzyme breaks down the cellulose into glucose for food. In a laboratory, cellulose can make glucose, which can make ethanol biofuel. Genetic engineers are developing powerful new enzymes. Assume that they accomplish their goal. Recombinant DNA gene splicing produces a rapid growth enzyme that breaks down cellulose much faster than nature. What happens if a bit escapes the lab and finds its niche in nature, where it explodes exponentially and is carried by the wind and jet streams around the world, killing all trees and exterminating everything that breathes oxygen? It could happen. The probability of a biofuel cataclysmic catastrophe is extremely low, but it is possible, just like the low probability of a nuclear power plant disaster. Chernobyl left one quarter of Belarus permanently uninhabitable. Humans do make serious mistakes in the pursuit of providing energy. There seems to be only one good thing about subsidizing biofuels from food. It buys votes for incumbents from farmers who apparently care nothing about their grandchildren's future legacy.